basically, when I got signed, I felt like I wasn't really entirely ready to do a record yet. And because I didn't have a set band at the time, I really needed some time to get that together, because I didn't want to just go into the studio with some songs and have anybody play on it and put it together. It was weird because I've always wanted to be a part of a band that had history together and played together for a while. The kind of band where maybe everybody didn't really play all that great, but it was a unit. So I spent a lot of time, I guess about a year's worth of time, writing songs and playing with a bunch of different people, to the point of when we finally recorded, I had it maybe about a year's history with some of the people, and then I went back and actually had old friends play on the record, people who for their own reasons in their lives couldn't commit to being in a band, but I had played with, so they understood what was going on, and it really, that was the best way that we were going to actually get that feeling of a unit recording the record. I would say we're a combination of both, as far as bands that have played together for a while, and then bands that just kind of go out and put together a tape and get a deal. Because I had played in the band Hours for a good number of years, probably around 6 years or so, and then I'd taken some time off, about 2 years off, and then started playing again, and within, say, like three shows, then some record labels started to come around. So it kind of felt like it happened quickly, but at the same time, you can lose track of, at that point, about 7 years in the making, so or it seems like it happened right away. In one sense, not really the case. For the most part, it's been really, really good. There are some little things here and there that, you know, like, If I wasn't signed to a major label, that I would have done differently. And not necessarily that I would have done them better, but just because I would have just maybe not looked at it from another angle. And I may have approached it differently. I mean, I had a few different record cover ideas that were a lot more, I would say, independent feeling. But, I mean, for the most part, like, right across the board, I mean, there's certain things due to, like, finances and deadlines that sometimes you have to just put something to bed. I'm concerned that we just stay on track with what we want to do, and that's write good songs and reach people and touch them in a way that I feel I want to do. That's why I write and play music. I mean, everybody has their own way and how they want to move people. To some people, it is all about rock music and turning it up loud and moving people in that way. To me, that's not what it's about, and it's just important to me that we not lose that. Sometimes after a tragedy or something, you have this moment where it makes you feel like, well, I really want to be a good person. I really want to be good to people and be aware and alert and alive. I would hope that somehow they get a glimpse of that feeling and try to remind themselves of that every day, because I think that's the key of being happy. It's not, I've never completely just woken up and say, oh, wow, I'm happy. I feel like there's so many things that I have to put into ingredients to put into the whole mix of things to be happy on an overall basis. So if this record can somehow, lyrically, musically, whatever it is, remind people that to look for that thing that makes them happy and try to remind themselves of that, that would, to me, that would be a good thing.